My name is James Noka, and I'm the owner of American Knife Company. We produce a knife called the Forest Knife, and it's in a sheath that has a magnet in it. And recently I've been reading on the interwebs some posts that were saying that the magnet will affect a compass. Well, I'm here to tell you that yes, it will affect a compass. And I've made a short little video explaining how it affects the compass and why it affects the compass and what you should watch out for while you're using a compass. Here's the video. Now my compass is this is a Kamminga mil spec compass, and I am going to film this using my little flip camera. I can't put this on a tripod because the tripod affects the compass, and that's going to be the point that I'm going to make with you. Let's see here. Let me get an angle that I'm not. There's a lot of glare out here today. I might have to film this somewhere else, this little section. But I guess you can see that. But as you see, if you take the knife out of the sheath, set it over there, and we're going to start moving the sheath into place, and you will see that yes, it does. It does affect the compass. Look how dramatically it affects the compass. Very dramatic. Okay? Now, here's a knife. Watch how much the knife affects the compass. Isn't that interesting? Okay, how about your headlamp? How about this headlamp? Will this headlamp affect it? Oh yeah, look at that. That's a pretty common bushcraft tool right there. I wonder why that's affecting it. How about if you happen to be going into the woods and you're taking your trusty Smith & Wesson, will that affect it? Oh. Well, look at that. So now, here's what I want to explain to you a little bit about. Compasses are affected by a lot of things. The problems arise when you're using your compass, and it's affected by something very subtle that you don't pick up on very quickly. A little bit, 1 degree off at your compass could be 100 yards off a quarter of a mile down the road, or a half a mile down the road, or a mile down the road, if you get what I mean. Okay, so obviously we notice that things affect your compass. The problem arises when you don't recognize your compass as being affected. Obviously, when you have your knife sheath and the magnet in the knife sheath spins the compass around, you know something's wrong. But if the gun on your hip is affecting your compass just ever so slightly, it's going to throw you off, and you're not going to even recognize that. And you're going to get to your end place, and you're going to go, wow, how could I be this far off? I'm not finding what I'm looking for. I followed my compass right to the T. And it really happens out on the water a lot when that's the only thing you have to go by. That's why a compass on a boat or a ship has to be compensated. They call it compensating. And it's obviously if you have a boat that's all metal, all steel, guess what? The whole steel boat full of iron ore affects a compass like none other. So what they do is they compensate it and they eliminate that magnetic pull from that iron. And that's what, you just have to understand that these things occur in nature. There's iron ore in the UP of Michigan, and it affects your compass. Little things, like I said, the big things, the knife sheath and the knife, that makes you aware that your compass is affected because you can see it. But beware of the subtleties of the minute changes in your compass that you won't recognize as being even a change. A handgun will do it. A handgun, batteries, headlamp, a lot of things will affect your compass that you don't even realize that it's being affected by it. So be careful when you're using your compass to make sure that you're clear of anything metallic is the best you can. And usually arm's reach away from it is plenty. I mean, if you, I'll do a demonstration of where this heavy magnet starts affecting this. And then you can gauge with your other metal how close it has to be to affect it. Sometimes it doesn't, and it depends on the size of the steel. You could be standing next to a car with your compass, and the car is gonna draw your compass a little bit off. So just be aware of it and compensate for it. Can't even measure right because okay, so, if it's within 6 inches, it is affecting your compass. Okay, so that's my little bit of advice today. Enjoy the outdoors, get out and play some. Talk to you next time. Have fun.